Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is the 17th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our Mass Presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphone. God is in His holy place, God who unites those who dwell in His house. He Himself gives might and strength to His people.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son. Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father. You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing is firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Our first readings from the Book of Kings. The Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream at night. God said, "Ask something of me, and I will give it to you." Solomon answered, "O Lord, my God, you have made me your servant, king to succeed my father David. But I am a mere youth, not knowing at all how to act. I serve you in the midst of the people whom you have chosen, a people so vast that it cannot be numbered or counted. Give your servant, therefore, an understanding heart to judge your people and to distinguish right from wrong. For who is able to govern this vast people of yours?" The Lord was pleased that Solomon made this request. So God said to him, "Because you have asked for this, not for a long life for yourself, nor for riches, nor for the life of your enemies, but for understanding so that you may know what is right, I do as you requested. I give you a heart so wise and understanding that there has never been anyone like you up to now, and after you there will come no one to equal you." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, I love your commands.
Lord, I love your commands.
I have said, O Lord, that my part is to keep your words. The law of your mouth is to me more precious than thousands of gold and silver pieces.
Lord, I love your commands.
Let your kindness comfort me according to your promise to your servants. Let your compassion come to me that I may live, for your law is my delight.
Lord, I love your commands.
For I love your commands more than gold, however fine. For in all your precepts I go forward. Every false way I hate.
Lord, I love your commands.
Wonderful are your decrees, therefore I observe them. The revelation of your words shed light, giving understanding to the people.
Lord, I love your commands.
Second reading, Letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, we know that all things work for good for those who love God, who are called according to His purpose. For those He foreknew, He also predestined to be conformed to the image of His Son, so that He might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those who predestined, He also called. And those He called, he also justified, and those who justified, he also glorified. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for you have revealed to little ones the mysteries of the kingdom. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in a field, which a person finds and hides again, and out of joy goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great price, he goes and sells all that he has and buys it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net thrown into the sea, which collects fish of every kind. When it is full, they will haul it ashore and sit down to put what is good into buckets. What is bad they throw away. Thus will it be at the end of the age. The angels will go out and separate the wicked from the righteous and throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. Do you understand all these things?" They answered, "Yes." And he replied, "Then every scribe who has been instructed in the kingdom of heaven is like the head of a household who brings from his storeroom both the new and the old." My dear brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, as I had mentioned, no, that today and then tomorrow also, no, I'd like to reflect on the gift of Ignatius of Loyola to the church, no. And today, you know, using the gospel, no, I'd like to reflect on this is the parable of the kingdom, no, the treasure and the pearl of great price. Of course, there's another part, the second half of the gospel, but I'll focus on the two parables, no. And for Ignatius, no, I think there are very special graces that he has given to the church, no. I will say more about him tomorrow, but today I'd like to focus on the spiritual exercises, no, which is probably, as many people would say, it is among the 10 most influential spiritual books, no, in for all times, no. And then I think when you take a look at that, at the spiritual exercises, it has given us, in a sense, the spirituality of Ignatius and therefore the spirituality of the Society of Jesus, the Jesuits, no. And then the retreat as we know it now really came from the spiritual exercises. So Ignatius is the patron of retreats. And then also spiritual discernment is a fruit of the spiritual exercises. Again, the Ignatius is considered as the father of spiritual discernment. And let me just invite you to reflect on three elements or graces in the spiritual exercises. Number one is, in the first week, he emphasizes self-awareness and self-acceptance. That's in the first week, no? And then the second week focuses a lot on commitment, no? And then this commitment is put to the test, so to speak, in the third week, no? And then finally, in the fourth and final week or part of the spiritual exercises, he focuses on the resurrection. But more specifically, he focuses on that beautiful prayer of commitment, no? And this will be the three points that we'd like to look at, no? First, about self-awareness, no? In the spiritual exercises, you realize that there is a pattern, no? There is a process in self-awareness. It begins with the positives, no? The blessings, so to speak, no? And then from there, as the process would go, it begins to focus now on the brokenness and the sinfulness, no? And I think that was a very deliberate process that Ignatius put in place, because he had a very terrific understanding of human nature. I think he was very gifted, no, in understanding human nature. That the bringing forward first of blessings and gratitude is to give a very solid foundation for one person to be confident, no, to face his or her shortcomings. No? As many spiritual writers would say, it's very hard to face one shortcomings. Diba? And even us, no, sometimes we find it difficult to confess, no, a sin, our sinfulness, no, and we struggle with that, no. So Ignatius, build on the positives so that the person may be more open, no, to be able to face and acknowledge his sinfulness or her shortcomings. And then this self-awareness, he deepens into self-acceptance. No? Again, it's a deeper form of awareness. And precisely the awareness is the graciousness of God, the blessings that we have received, and therefore it is an awareness that leads to gratitude. And at the same time, it is also an awareness that makes us accept our shortcomings, no? our sinfulness, so to speak. No? But the interesting thing is in all this, especially in that process of acceptance, one now discovers the love of God. That really awareness and acceptance becomes an awareness and acceptance of God's love. In our blessedness, it is a gracious and generous love. In our sinfulness and brokenness, it is the healing, merciful, and forgiving love of God. So this is that first point, no? The awareness and the acceptance leads to an awareness and acceptance of God's love. which brings us to the second week, no? In the second week, he says, pray for this particular grace. Lord, that I may see you more clearly, love you more dearly, follow you more nearly. And here you realize that this awareness of God's presence and God's love is the basis now of the desire to see Christ more clearly. And that seeing Christ more clearly is placed within the context or the story of the Gospels. No? So now we begin to see now the person of Christ, deepen that relationship. And then precisely, it is in that relationship now that we see the love of God expressed through Christ. No? That's why to see Christ more clearly in our life and through the story of the Gospels, one now realizes that yes, God, Christ is present in our life. And it is a presence of love. That's why the second movement of the grace is to love you more dearly. And Ignatius would say, you know, that in the end, we actually return love for love. That we are able to love because God loved us first. No? Remember in that beautiful scene in the movie, Ignacio de Loyola. Now I think it's available in Prime Video. No, it is. Yeah, you can look at it. No, and that beautiful scene of his conversion, and that is supposedly the vision of the River Cardoner. No, wherein Ignatius professes his love, and then the Lord tells Ignatius, "Remember, I loved you first," and that is for me now, Ignatius loving Jesus in return, and for Ignatius, to love is to express it in deeds. So it is now to love by following Christ. It is now a commitment to be a companion in mission. And then the third and final point is that it is a commitment, a total commitment. In that beautiful prayer at the end of the fourth week, at the end of the exercises, Ignatius makes that prayer, "Take and receive, O Lord." And the very end of the prayer says, "Give me only your love and your grace. These make me rich. I ask for nothing more." So that now is the total offering. It is only the love and grace of God that matters. And this is the pearl of great price. This is the treasure for which you will give up everything. This is the treasure. Siguro maganda na pag nilaya natin, di ba, yung spiritual exercise ni San Ignacio. Dahil nga sa unang bahagi, yung unang punto, malinaw sinasabi niya, kailangan maging mulat tayo, no? Sa ating kabutihan, sa biyayang binigay ng Diyos, at maging mulat din tayo sa ating mga pagkukulang, sa ating pagiging makasalanan. Ngunit sa lahat ng yan, makikita natin na ang pagkamulat sa ating mga biyaya, ang pagkamulat sa ating pagkukulang, at ang pagtanggap dito, ang ating namumulatan at namamalayan at nakikita sa ating buhay ang pag-ibig ng Diyos. Ang pag-ibig na nagbigay sa atin ng lahat ng biyaya, ang pag-ibig na nagpapatawad sa ating mga kasalanan, ang pag-ibig na humihilom sa lahat ng ating sugat. At mula diyan, pumapasok dun sa pangalawang punto, no? Nasabi nga ni San Ignacio dun sa kanyang spiritual exercises sa second week, ano, ang pagninilay sa buhay ng Panginoon ayon sa Ebanghelyo, sabi niya, hilingin natin na makita natin ang Panginoon ng higit na malinaw at mahalin natin siya ng higit na taimtim at malalim at sumunod sa Kanya ng mas malapit. Ano? At makikita natin na ito ay isang proseso. No?
Kasi pag nakita natin ang Panginoon na nasa pang-araw-araw na buhay natin, ang kanyang presensya ay presensya ng pag-ibig. At sabi nga ni San Ignacio, ang tugon sa pag-ibig ay ang pagbabalik ng pag-ibig natin sa kanya. At yung pag-ibig na ito ay pinakamagandang mapakita sa aksyon, ang pagsunod sa Panginoon bilang kasama niya sa misyon. At yung kabuuan, at ito yung tatlo at pangatlong hulit punto, ang kabuuan ng pagtatalaga ng ito ay nasa pang-apat na linggo ng spiritual exercises. Di ba yung napakaganda niyang dasal? Yung kunin mo o Diyos at tanggapin mo? Sa katapusan ng dasal, anong sabi ng San Ignacio? Ipagkaloob mo lamang ang biyaya at pag-ibig mo at sapat na ito sa akin. Yan ang kabuuan ng pag-aalay ng ating sarili sa Diyos. Give me only your love and your grace, and I ask for nothing more. I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
God our Father has given us the gift of faith as a treasure and a pearl of great price. Let us continue to cherish the gift and this gift and share it with people around us by living up to the demands of our faith. Let us pray, Father, reveal to us the mysteries of... Let us pray, Lord, hear our prayer.
That Pope Francis and all church leaders may work tirelessly toward making the kingdom of heaven permeate and be proclaimed to all nations and people, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May we hold to our faith and values and see them as true and lasting treasures and not be seduced by the passing joys of power, prestige, and pleasure, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the leaders of nations work for prosperity and progress without forgetting human dignity and the gospel's value, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Again, we continue to pray for those who were affected by the recent typhoon. For all this, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which you bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life, and lead us to eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being, and while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with Saint Ignatius of Loyola, and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now let us offer our prayer of humble faith and hope.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come before you in faith and hope. Grant us your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. We thank you for the blessings that saw us through the challenges of the past years. Reward those who selflessly serve and continue to serve our many needs. Console those who suffered. Heal the sick. Grant eternal rest to those who died. May we draw inspiration from our collective and individual experiences. Let our hearts burn within us to build a world closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, peace, joy, faith, hope, compassion, and love. May each of us be a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. We pray for our nation. Give us the courage and inspiration to relentlessly take part in the project of building a nation that our founding fathers envisioned over a century ago and to which succeeding generations offered their lives in dedicated service, some to the point of martyrdom. Heroes all, so Filipinos may continue to work for freedom and someday truly be free. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception, Patroness of the Philippines,
pray for us.
Our Lady, Help of all Christians and Health of the Sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us. And let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the Passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat. And again, please join us for Journeys of Hope after this. It's now the second part of the Pista ng Pag-asa, the commitment night of Ale Kapwa expanded campaign. No? Very inspiring, the pledge and the blessing of the nuncio, and then the singing of the classic Paraiso by Ryan Cayabyab to be sung by BGYO. No? So please join us and also meet the ambassadors of Ale Kapwa. Then also Proyecto Pilipino talking about the coming barangay elections. Maraming pong salamat. Have a blessed and prayerful Sunday. Thank you.
I can't feed 5,000, but I can feed one. I can't walk in water, but I can walk in the shoes of another. Sharing what I have in my hands is the miracle that needs to be seen today. This is what I can share. This is my Alay Kapwa. Alay Kapwa, a flagship program of Caritas Philippines by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines.